Most people in America are accustomed to what is and isn't lawful assessment. And what I feel about my life is not what you may feel about your own life. But what you feel about your life is not what might not be what I feel about your life. But the reality is you have no right to comment about my life. You are not living my life in the day today. And when I need to take a break, for me, there are very few places that a person can be when they're fighting through the struggles of homeless. But homelessness is caused by a lot of things. But it can be caused by ill-willed siblings, ill-willed relatives, and asinine behavior of police departments that destroy our rights to move freely in a community. It is called stalking under federal law. It is absolutely called mobbing when it involves military or police, and openly medical practitioners, as you might hear from Lisa Bayou's final use of a word she's heard most likely from me and then decided to utilize, is the word gaslighting. And gaslighting is when officers and other people in a community try to push someone's psycho-emotional buttons. It's incredibly immoral in front of the house of God. It is illegal because it's a form of harassment. But when people lie to us about being friends, when they lie to us till the very end, when they send people to see us, but those people don't actually stop to talk to us, it makes us angry. Anger and rage is a healthy emotion. Even the world's greatest magician of all time, Jesus Christ, was angry in the temples. He was turning over the coffers of the priests and the persons who call themselves pastors today, and ministers who clean house off of the tithings of their constituents, their parishioners, their members of their churches, and their organizations. And yet they go out there and they forget the attitudes of Jesus. They forget that Jesus pretty much would be a guy today wearing blue jeans. And Jesus in Blue Jeans is an interesting read as a authored work, but it's not mine. Much like Bill Hybels' Just Walk Across the Room in Evangelism is not a work of mine, but I have read the work and I know what it's about. The truth is my library of photographs have been deleted offline. Who gave any child of any American citizen or any world country the right to play in my intellectual property, the right to ruin my copywritten photographs, the right to abuse and sexually assault my body, the right to interfere with my practices of medical rights? The Asians and the Indians and the Muslims who are here do those things in spite and in games. And openly, I'm not a plaything of anything. The liars of America like to play games in YouTube. They like to create audios and videos, then they backdate those. That's great. But what are you psychologically studying? Are you psychologically studying someone who's smarter than you, or are you psychologically studying someone who's dumber than you? And I hate to say it that way, because people look at these alignments and go, holy shit, she's perfect for me. And then you look at the date and go, well, that was 3 years ago, so maybe this is a play. But the point of a FBI play is not to assess someone, not to push on their buttons, and not to put them to rage. But your harassment and your sexual harassment and your sexual assault of a man in America is not okay. The liars of America, the liars of the world say it only happens to women and female embodied persons. But the reality is the soul is a soul and it belongs to God. So when men assault men, under the law, when men ruin records of other men, they have violated federal law. You see, you had no lawful rights to any privacy records or any medical records or even any mental health records on anyone at all. American rights are under siege today, and they're under siege today in every way. Politicians are utilizing their sieges to ruin history, to ruin heritage, to ruin standards of processes. Standard operating procedures are what we have existed on. It's what we live on. It's what we thrive on. It's how we ensure quality in America today. It's how we ensure safety and the sanctity of food today. But it's also how we ensure the security of persons today. Human trafficking, information trafficking, technological abuses are running rampant across America. And it's being handled by children who have done nothing in their life at all. They're in their 20s, they're in their early 30s, and have they been married? Have they been a parent? Have they done anything to build a business or a small representation of themselves and the services that they provide for a community? I think not. They're an hourly employee in a paltry job, pissing all over the homeless, poo-pooing their friendships not at all with the peddlers and the panhandlers of the streets. And openly a manager will say, I don't like them here, and another manager will keep them here by feeding them. And there's nothing wrong with feeding another human being. Even Jesus fed the masses. But personally pursuing one person at a time and pretending that that person is someone else is abuse of the Lord's house. Now, some of the things I may say would be maybe perfect and rhyme. Other things I may say may be political of some kind. But openly, if I make a misstep, it's because my brain is moving so fast or so slow, depending on your perspective. Your perspective of my life doesn't matter to me. But my excitement, my enthusiasm, my drive in my life belongs to me. But when elder siblings attacked my life with the help of local sheriff, local police, it destroyed a man's life. When the love of my entire existence ruined my life with her foolish, immature calls to police because she couldn't tell an old-fashioned man falling in love with the girl who set him ablaze and on fire, then that was the foolishness of her life.